Last week's Learning Kung Fu Channel, this is Sifu JJ. Today, video, how to transfer Kung Fu movement to a real application. Let's follow up the three Chinese martial arts masters. They are talking about what is the Kung Fu's future, how transfer Kung Fu movement become a real application. Let's go.
Wu Deng, the professor of Beijing Sport Wushu College.
He believes wushu athletes need to train more real application in order to improve their form or 套路. Wushu athletes has great speed, power, body condition with a scientific way training.
But wushu lose the intention of a fight because wushu is a competition event. When coach teaching them, more focus on their movement you have to correct because they have a rule and standard they have to follow, the only way to make them winning. But they forgot to telling students why you doing this movement, why you doing this punch, why you doing this kick. Sanda is another part of Chinese martial arts. It's full contact event, more like kickboxing plus wrestling. But you cannot say any wushu or kung fu movement right there. Master Wu Deng really want to merge these two events to be together, wushu and sanda. Wushu athletes can fight, they really can fight. Just they don't have the intention and no one to telling them what is the intention for fight using their wushu movements. Many of wushu athletes, they transfer wushu to sanda, they gain result very quickly because they have a great condition for fighting. Master Wu Deng also mentioned wushu is a beautiful art, influencing thousands of people to learning this art, but wushu must be self-defense and not hard at all, just transfer the intention. Master Wu Deng also trust Chinese martial arts have a beautiful future. They will be into Olympic one day. Master Zhang Zizhong also trust practice real application to improve wushu form is necessary. He teaching real fight technique for short weapon. Chinese martial arts start with army from a war. So from a war, people are holding their spears and sword to fight. And the movement technique is simply just for attack or defense. He pushing his student from wushu form training, take movement to a real application training, which is really work out, really improve their intention for form training as well. He helps students wear all equipment to protect themselves for training, and he trusts the best way to defend yourself is you've been attacked. Master Zhang Zizhong to encourage their students to using Kung Fu and Wushu movement to fight as much as possible to improve their intention in their forms training. Shaolin Master 释延辉 is a very strict coach.
这是实战装，不是马步装啊，是实战装。只有实战装才会最有利于实战，听明白没有？
啊，
这个实战装的劲儿发于后腿，它起身的时候是靠后腿蹬起来的。你看，是靠后腿蹬的，对方一来，这一勾挂就出了。你看，哎，手要摆啊，哎，走，看到没有？你顶不住，你这个手也拨不开，你拨不开，你就是这个下场。人家打实战球，人家给你玩命的，是吧？这是拳，是吧？你拳都拨不开，他们是把刀呢？啊，走，嗯，走。
刚开始是这里面可以上三组、四组的，在这里面练习。
其实，释延资的做法在传统武术的民间传承中，并不被广泛接受和认可。很多人以擂台规则限制传统武术技术发挥为由，回避上擂台。
都一样，啊，只要站在这个位置，啊，守住自己的阵地就可以走。哎，跑起来啊！接下来我们讲一下啊，小红拳里面的一个劈腿斜行啊，这么一个实战动作，护着头，你看，啊，压手缩身，啊，上步，劈腿。啊，弓步斜行，比如说蹬腿蹬过来压着它之后的话，进行继续旋转到这里来，你看，嗯，到这里面来才可以，这才得手，这叫得手了啊。然后呢，上步，你看这手插过来这挑它啊，你抱着我，我这一挑你抱着我你就摔不倒了啊，哎，啪啊，啊，你就老了，你看这一挑到啪，
传统武术到现在的这个局面，个人认为还是对实战的这种训练不够，通过实践来检验我们的每一招每一式能不能够用上，只有通过这种方法。
释延资说，接受西方的搏击规则并不意味着全盘放弃中国武术的传统训练方法，比如推石鼓，采用传统的训练方法，释延资还有另一层考虑，他担心单调的练法会留不住年轻人浮躁的心。
因为孩子们嘛，他们的心都不定，我才会有更多的徒弟跟我学，相信我。
星星，
这一年的冬天，登峰刚刚下过第一场雪，我们再次与释延资相见，希望他能再为我们打一次少林小红拳。看着眼前的他，不知道为什么，这一次我在心里默默地慨叹，延资老了，英雄暮年，但壮心不已。
功夫永远是属于那些自强不息、坚持不懈的人。我抱着这么一个梦想，永不放弃。我想这个天下不是只我一个人。
的确，不止释延资。